Oh no! AC family, looking into the nest now, it was completely empty. The Polyrhachis ants were all gone. What happened? And shortly after their disappearance, something absolutely mind-boggling happened that left me speechless. What is this? Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family. Enjoy. Before we get to what this eerie, mysterious mist is that appeared floating on the waters of El Dragon last week, we needed to address where our Polyrhachis ants went and what has happened leading up to this phenomenon. AC family, you will want to keep watching until the end for this epic ant story. So I have been showing our past few weeks of videos of our Polyrhachis ants to my myrmecologist and ant taxonomist friend David General from the University of the Philippines, Los Baños, a man who has dedicated his life to studying and classifying ants of the Philippines. Needless to say, he has been super impressed with our video documentation of some extremely eye-opening footage on these Polyrhachis ants of ours, which he said were greatly unstudied. As you saw in our video 2 weeks ago, David first mentioned to me that the feeding ecology of our Polyrhachis seminermis ants was unknown. They didn't know what they ate or how they ate it. But we discovered in our video that the ants fed on sweet liquids like honey, as well as insect parts. We were even amazed to discover that the queen even leaves the comfort and safety of the nest to feed with her workers. Which is quite interesting and unique, since the queens of most species rarely ever leave the nest unless they absolutely need to. Finally, we even watched as a worker regurgitated some strange black pellet before diving into a cockroach leg, meat from which it ripped off during feeding. David was so intrigued by all of this and said, "Wow, great work! You're on the way to accumulating enough observations for a behavioral paper. Does a paper in insect social sound interesting to you?" I told him, not so much. But I allowed him to use our footage in case he or his associates wanted to write that research paper. But our only condition was, he had to credit the AC family. Can you imagine that together we contributed to science? Super cool, AC family. But that's not all. Over the next few weeks, I was able to shoot some other pretty amazing things. New AC family discoveries. Another thing Dave mentioned to me earlier on was that the biology of many Polyrhachis species is unknown. In fact, I've never seen them bring solid food to the nest. They somehow take protein in their crops home to the nest. Well, 2 weeks ago, I placed a small spider near the nest and one worker came, picked it up, and brought it home. Bam! Another contribution to science from the AC family. And check out this Polyrhachis ant pooping. You don't see that every day. And in literally 1 minute, the poop drop was gone. The telangia plant, which absorbs nutrients and water through hair-like structures called trichomes, drank up all of that nutritious ant poo. I told this to Dave and he said, "There's a new paper proving ant plants are fertilized by ant poop on the leaves." Good show for the telangia. And good show for us as well. We just supported that paper. But one major thing scientists have apparently been wondering was which larval instar in these Polyrhachis ants produces the silk needed to construct their leaf homes. You see, these ants use the silk webbing produced by their larvae to glue leaves and debris together to create amazing nests in the leaves of plants and similar environments. We saw this last week when our Polyrhachis were nest building. They took pieces of sphagnum moss and cotton, which we provided to them in a container, back home to the nest to glue together and form a cozy sanctuary for the queen and brood. But allegedly, myrmecologists have always wondered and haven't had an opportunity to study the web-building process of these Polyrhachis ants. And so their big question was, which stage of larva creates the webbing? Now, as a backgrounder, in these Polyrhachis ants, there are 5 larval stages known as instars. The first instar being the smallest larva, and the 5th instar being the last and largest, right before pupation. After our Polyrhachis ants moved perfectly onto El Dragon Island here, I was really hoping to catch our ants nest building and help answer that big question. But now it seems our Polyrhachis have disappeared. Where could they have gone? I checked everywhere. I searched every plant, root area, and soil. I checked the waters for drowned ants. I saw none. Could our shrimps have eaten them that fast? Impossible that our new Rasbora fish ate them. They were too tiny. Did they escape somehow? It was all just so perplexing to me. I sat for a moment and stared into the beautiful chaos of Eldragon's landscape. Could the dragon's curse from the days of the Garden of Eden be back? No, this is impossible. This is a science channel. We don't believe in curses. Plus, even if it was, it just can't be. This is a brand new tank, brand new era, brand new home. Oh no, brand new home? AC family, there's something that I did forget to mention. Some of the soils used to create the island in which Eldragon's plants grow were taken from the Garden of Eden. Perhaps our curse has indeed passed on to these Polyrhachis? I stared at our dragon skull, which was set on the stone to appease the spirit of the great dragon who once lived in these lands. And then, it hit me. The skull! I looked into the dragon skull, and lo and behold, our Polyrhachis ants were there. Nestled into the comfy hollows of one of the horns, and greatest of all, AC family, look! The workers were using a larva to spin silk and glue debris to form their new nest gate. Wow! AC family, we just solved the mystery. These Polyrhachis ants use the fifth instar, the most mature larva, to spin their silk. High five, guys. We just answered the big scientific question, as well as our own mystery as to where our Polyrhachis disappeared to. But there was one final mystery left. What was that eerie mist that appeared last week on Eldragon's waters? Well, when I discovered the ants moved into the skull last week, one of the things that concerned me was that the ants no longer could benefit from the transpiration that naturally happens in plants. You see, ants that build nest homes in leaves benefit from the humidity that the plants give off during transpiration. Transpiration is the process by which moisture is carried through the plants from roots to small pores on the underside of leaves, where it changes to vapor and is released to the atmosphere. So, weaver ants like these Polyrhachis have natural humidifiers in their homes, which is pretty darn cool. But in this completely dry skull, I feared the ants might not be able to get the same amount of humidity as they would had they lived in the plants. So, I decided to give them something to help solve that. A fogger, which I placed on a timer to schedule the creation of a mini mist every few hours in order to give our Polyrhachis ants some humidity support. Every 3 hours, a creeping mist, like the breath of a dragon, covers the surface of the waters and keeps ambient humidity ideal for our ants. Are you ready for this, AC family? The best part about all of this? It obscures the path and makes it hostile traveling ground for our pharaoh ant interlopers. If any pharaoh ants get too close to the mist, they have a high chance of falling into the water and being eaten by our mosquito Rasbora fish. Many pharaoh ants now turn away when the mist blows in. I loved watching the mist floating on Eldragon's waters, which, by the way, thanks to your votes, is now officially called the River of Dragon's Tears. As for our shrimp colony living in the waters, they also officially have a name. You name them the Leviathans. I like those names. And of course, last week you guys voted for an official name for our Polyrhachis ants, and AC family, I am happy to announce these ants are now called the Black Dragons. Thank you guys for always being so enthusiastic at participating in these ant videos and for being a huge part of their fate. Thanks to you, we contribute to the ant success And, as we've seen in this video, to some amazing discoveries in science. It seems our black dragons, which continue to work through the night, building their nest in the skull of Eldragon, will be okay. We'll just have to keep providing them with everything they need and hope they succeed. This Eldragon Paludarium setup was such a huge success. It made me look over to our black dragon's neighbors, the Golden Empire, in their Hacienda del Dorado. Our yellow crazy ants have been living in this terrarium for over a year. Look at all that chaos. The Hacienda del Dorado was in desperate need of a makeover. We also had to find another way to deal with their exploding population. And I had just the renovation to solve both those problems. AC family, behold. Alright, AC family, are you excited for what's up next for our Golden Empire? These yellow crazy ants are up for a royal renovation, and I can't wait for you guys to see what I've done. Tune in next week to catch how I turned their current overrun terrarium into one of the craziest ant setups I've ever created in all my years of ant keeping. You won't want to miss it, so hit that subscribe button and bell icon, and hit the like button every time, including now. AC Inner Colony, I have left a hidden cookie for you here if you would just like to watch some extended play footage of our scientific discoveries, as well as our groundbreaking discovery of the black dragons spinning silk using their fifth instar larvae. Spread the word, the AC family saw it first. Before continuing to the AC question of the week, I wanted to plug my new daily vlogging channel, featuring my daily vlogs for those wondering what I work on between these weekly ant videos. And now it's time for the AC question of the week. Last week we asked, how do beneficial bacteria help keep fish alive in an aquarium? Congratulations to, and note this was completely a random selection, Ant Love Forever, who correctly answered, the fish's waste makes toxic ammonia, which is converted by bacteria into nitrite, and then again into nitrate. Congratulations, Ant Love Forever, you just won a free ebook handbook from our shop. In this week's AC question of the week, we ask, list any of the ant scientific discoveries we made in this video. Leave your answer in the comment section, and you could also win a free ebook handbook from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's Ant Love Forever.